initially wrote this theme, it was supposed to be right at the beginning, you know, to sort of to symbolize the water, the sea.
Yeah.
That little sea feel around it. And I actually prefer it when it comes back over here.
So Dana and I are writing a new musical, brand new musical, which is called Broken Wings, and it's an adaptation of a novel by Khalil Gibran. It's a love story, it's a very emotional story, and it's set in Lebanon, which is where I'm from. And we've been working on this for 18 months, roughly, and this week here in Doha, we have just finished the final three songs. So I think we have a complete score. And over the next few months, we're going to be fine-tuning it and finessing it into something that will hopefully come alive next year.
Nadeem and I met a year and a half ago in London. I was opening for a composer called Guy Manoukian at Cadogan Hall, and a mutual friend of ours thought that Nadeem and I would have the perfect artistic collaboration. So he suggested that I go to Phantom of the Opera, where Nadeem was playing Raoul. My daughter was a huge fan, so am I, obviously. And so it was the perfect setup. We went to the show, and right after the show, he arranged for Nadeem and I to meet. And within the first 10 minutes, we both established the fact that we always wanted to write a musical. And Nadeem being in the world of musical and theater for the past 10 years was already fully immersed in the idea of what it was that he wanted to do. And that set the framework for the next year and a half.
Yeah, we've got two takes and you can shoot.
Okay, so how many beats are you going to give me?
It's one bar, so four beats.
It sounds really good though. It sounds really good.
Yeah.
Bang on.
Seriously?
Yeah, yeah, just go back to the top of the chorus.
I think when Dana and I began work on it, we never would have imagined the efficiency with which we could create something like this, which was probably ironically helped by the fact that we live in two different countries. It meant that we had to be precious with our time and commit to writing things, sharing across the internet and using WhatsApp to send melodies back and forth. And we just very quickly set up a really nice timeline with mini deadlines, and I'd send Dana some lyrics and she'd send me a song within 3 days, and then I'd send her a song and say, what do you think of this? And we ended up with a really like even 50-50 split. We have actually ultimately written 7 songs each for this. So maybe that saved time, the fact that there were 2 of us composing in 2 different places rather than one of us trying to do 14 songs.
So I think we just really understood what we wanted to get out of this musical, what the feeling was, what the ideology was. And we both came from a similar space musically, even though we're fundamentally different as artists. So there was so it was very easy to merge those two areas together.
Every time I hit that high note, I want to laugh. Because I'm like, it's almost ticklish.
Gibran he's the Shakespeare of the Middle East. It's quite incredible really how little he's discussed and his work is known in the West. I live in London, I'm half English and I've spent my whole life there, and you know, people are familiar with him, but only people who have a connection to the Middle East. Gibran is the third best-selling poet of all time. In North America, his books have sold over 10 million copies. And what first gave us this idea of exploring him was the relevance that he still has in modern day, bearing in mind that he was a Middle Eastern immigrant who went to Boston in the States over 100 years ago and wrote a book that 10 million Americans bought. And, you know, there's been an awful lot of dialogue in the last year or two about immigrants and refugees and people leaving the oppression of the Middle East and starting a new life in the West. So this is all very relevant to Gibran.
This book is the definitive point of Khalil Gibran's entire career. His experience, the human aspect of it, is essentially what gives us the Gibran that has become such an iconic figure. So I feel like what will resonate with the audience is the layers of Gibran that we're not familiar with previously. We've all read The Prophet, we've all read his poems, and those are beautiful philosophical musings that resonate strongly in people, because it's just it's a general code and a general reflection on the state of life in the universe that you don't get very often. So I feel like Broken Wings will explain and will give people a wider perspective on where all of his future works came from.
I think two things. Firstly, the fact that it's autobiographical, is written in the first person, he's the narrator. So it immediately is an opportunity to get to know him, which not many people have had. He's writing in the present day, in Boston, in his 30s or 40s, and he's talking about his experience as an 18-year-old falling in love for the first time. And that double time frame, the present day and the past, leads to a really good structure for a stage show, I think.
I think the emphasis right now in the Middle East is creating content, creating original content. I think that what this musical will bring to actors, aspiring singers, is the idea that the world of theater or the artistic world, the international musical community, is not as saturated as people would assume. There's always room for new ideas, there's always room for innovation, there's always room for development. And in the Middle East, we have, specifically in Qatar, we have incredible facilities to spearhead growth in the cultural sectors. So I feel like there's going to be, and I hope that there's going to be, a boom in young actors, young musicians, and it will give them an outlet and a channel to target their objectives towards.
So the next step is to record a concept album. We want people to hear the songs before anything else, which we're going to be doing in January, February next year. Certainly we'll start it around then. And beyond that, we're going to launch the show in London with a big concert at some point in the summer. Hopefully people will really like it, and from that concert and from the feedback we get and the audience that we get, we'll find out whether there's appetite for the show elsewhere. And the plan then will be to take the show international. And of course bring it to the Middle East, because it's our home and it's Gibran's home, and we really want to give the Middle East their own musical. There's an awful lot of The Sound of Music comes to Beirut, or Les Mis goes to Dubai, or you know, Jersey Boys goes to Dubai. We want to do our own show that's for the Middle East. So hopefully within the next year or two, audiences who are very familiar with Gibran and who respect him a great deal will have this show on their doorstep. Fingers crossed.